everything. But yes, Alhamdulillah, we still have a chance to meet today. So I hope you all doing happy today. So I'm sure that some of you has your own activities, and some of you perhaps still try to commit with join with this TOEFL class. Okay, right. So what did you do, guys, on last weekend? Knowing that I noticed that you didn't have a class for Friday and Saturday, right? It's kind of free for ya, perhaps. Seneng ya, kemarin juga aku nggak belajar ya. Okay, great. So without any further ado, so let's continue. All right. So last time we had discussed about listening for short conversation, and I already shared you some of skills. Which is first is focus on the second line, and then number two, find the synonym, and then number three is avoid similar sound. Nah, today we're gonna try to take a look on the structure. So for some of you that thinks structure is easy or difficult for you, so it's a time for you. So let me ask you guys. So somebody here think that structure is your skill? Ada yang merasa senang dengan structure TOEFL?
No, ma'am.
No. Okay. So what do you think about the structure TOEFL?
Very difficult.
It's difficult. Okay. So what are you good at from the three comprehension in TOEFL? Are you good in listening, structure, or reading?
Structure and reading.
Reading.
Good. That's good. So some of you think that good in reading. Wow. I always admire and what is it? Somebody who love reading in TOEFL, and then I would like, oh my God, that's so fantastic. It's because for me, myself, I really hate reading TOEFL. It's so difficult, but I had to do that, right? I have to finish it. I have to finish all of the comprehension, but I'm not really like, if I may say, I'm not really like into reading. Well, okay. So guys, tell me, whenever you think that structure is difficult for you, which one? Which part? Susahnya itu di mana sih menurut kalian structure TOEFL itu?
All parts.
All parts, right. All parts ya, berarti semua ya. So as we know, structure, as I mentioned before, so structure, there are two sections. The first is multiple choices, pilihan ganda, which is you have to find which one is the best answer. So you need to read, ada nyamuk, tak ceplek. So you need to read the whole sentences, and then you need to find which one is the best answer from the choices, the four choices, A, B, C, D. And then the second section is written expressions. The written expressions itu yang dicari apanya, guys? Kalau dari written expression. Somebody know? Yang dicari apanya kalau dari written expression? Anybody know maybe? So from the written expression, the written expressions, we should find which one is incorrect. Ya, mana yang dari tulisan biasanya kan digaris gitu kan ya. Nah, mana which one that is incorrect, right? Mana yang kurang tepat dari kalimat tersebut. Nah, so which one from the two that you think it's easier? Mana dari menurut kalian yang mudah, guys? Is it written expressions or multiple choices? Somebody wanna say?
All is difficult, ma'am.
Both of them, yeah. So both of them are difficult. Okay, then. Yeah. All right. So whenever you think that structure is difficult, yes, it's the time for you. Habis ini pasti ini ya. Semoga jangan menambahin mumet kalian ya. Okay. So let me share this one.
Dar. Kayaknya mbak jangono tak dar.
Nak naik kene lo. Nak nunggu kene.
Sorry, Miss Eva, noise.
It's okay, ya. It's kind of breaking. Iklan, gak apa-apa itu. Okay, guys. So, as I mentioned before, there are two parts, yeah. There is multiple choices. Multiple choices means find the best answer. Right? Mencari jawaban yang benar, right? Nah, terus ada lagi nanti that is
number two.
Untuk peserta mohon
ayo makan nih kurang anu nek ngusih
anjir dulu di mute. Thank you.
Right, and then for the written expressions means mencari kata yang salah atau kurang tepat. Right. Great. So that's for the multiple choices. Masih pada ingat nggak guys kemarin? How many questions? How many numbers in a structure? Ada yang masih ingat? Ada berapa soal sih di structure? Mbak Ita, do you remember how many questions? How many numbers in the tuple structure? So there are 40 numbers, yeah, 40 numbers. So 15 number is multiple choices, right? Jadi pilihan gandanya itu 15, if I'm not mistaken. And then selebihnya adalah written expressions. Masih pada ingat kan ya contoh dari soal written expression? So, example, right? Let me give you some example, right? Right. So, example, this is and then okay, so I have a sentence. She eats banana yesterday. Which one do you think is the best answer, guys? Kalau ada pertanyaan kayak gini, soal kayak gini, jawabannya yang mana nih?
Yang B, Miss.
Sorry?
Yang B.
Yes, right. So B ya, it's supposed to be apa jawabannya jadi?
It
ya, betul. It's because the context is yesterday. So it means kata karena what is it? It's already in the past bentuk lampau. Jadi kata kerjanya harus kata kerja bentuk lampau. Okay, atau verb 2 ya biasa kita bilang. Okay, that's good. So for written expressions kita mencari jawab kata yang salah atau yang kurang tepat dari kalimat tersebut. Oke. Okay. Oke, okay, everyone. So, let's get it out now. So, nah, Miss, untuk skill and strategy. So, for the written expressions and multiple choices, because it has the same strategic and tips and tricks ya. Jadi baik untuk written expressions or untuk multiple choice skill sama trik sama tipsnya sama. So the very first one is this one. You need to find which is in a word in a sentence. It must be have one subject and one. This one. Subject and one verb. Jadi begini. I usually say to my students, right? Well, structure is really complicated and detailed, guys. It has a lot of parts. Ada bagiannya tuh banyak gitu ya, right? Even not in English ya, in bahasa itself it's really complex, sangat complex, right? Ada subjek, ada kata kerja, ada predikat, ada objek, ada kata keterangan, right? In bahasa we say it. Nah, almost same like in bahasa, which is in English, it also consists of subject, SPOK, what we call, yeah, or in bahasa, or in English, yeah, subject, verb, and then object, right? Nah, verb itself, it consists a lot of types, right? Kata kerja sendiri itu banyak, right? Jenisnya, ada kata kerja beraturan, ada kata kerja tidak beraturan, right? Wih, banyak pokoknya, ya. Nah, my suggestion is whenever you face with the structure questions, you need to identify, right? You need to identify every single word, right? You need to, you don't need to understand, ya. Nggak perlu harus tahu artinya ini apa sih. But at least memang harus tahu, which is this is the noun, this is the verb, this is the adjective, this is the adverb, right? Nah, before I go further, I'm gonna ask you. Pasti sudah tahu kan ya subjek itu apa? Subjek is ya subjek ya. Namanya subjek itu di depan, which is it is noun, right? Atau kata benda, right? Nah, Miss, tapi kata kadang itu subjek itu nggak hanya kata benda loh, Miss. Ada yang verb. Contohnya shopping. Nah, contohnya berbelanja adalah hobiku, right? Nah, itu kan pasti itu kan jadinya shopping. Nah, shopping itu kan kata kerja gitu kan. Your question. Yes, that's right. That's definitely right, which is shopping in this term of the sentence. Shopping is a noun. Kenapa kok dia fungsinya as a noun? Tetap sebagai noun because the position is in the beginning. Di awal dari sebuah kalimat, yeah. Seperti itu. Okay. So, my suggestion is, kalau nemu soal TOEFL structure, dipretelin dulu one by one. Kita identify this is the subject, this is the verb, this is the object, adverb, or adjective. Setelah sudah tahu, nah, pastikan that the sentence have subject and have one verb. Nggak boleh double, begitu. Nah, kalau double boleh, but it means kalimat tersebut banyak klausanya. Right. Nah, miss klausa itu what? Ini banyak ini yang cakupannya. So, klausa say right here. It's a group of words that consists subject and verb. Jadi, itu adalah kumpulan kata-kata tapi dia terdiri dari subject dan verb. Nah, ada beberapa kalimat itu yang that consists more than two clauses or three clauses. Bisa, sebuah kalimat itu boleh terdiri dari banyak klausa, right? Tapi harus dan wajib ada tanda hubung dan konektor atau bisa kita sebut penghubung ya atau tanda baca. Example in bahasa I said aku makan, kamu belajar, kan aku makan, koma, kamu belajar, koma, dia tidur, koma, tapi di mereka makan. Nah, itu sentence with multiple clauses. kalimat dengan banyak klausa dan itu aman. It's right. Sudah betul karena tercakup terdiri dari subject and verb. Aku makan, subject sama verb, right? Satu subject, satu verb. Kamu belajar, subject sama verb, right? So it's true, boleh ya. Nah, itu yang dinamakan sentence with multiple clauses. Nah, sekarang, apa bedanya clause and phrases? Nah, phrases is a group of words. Okay, let me write. Group of words that not consist of subject and verb. Jadi katanya itu panjang gitu loh. Right? Contohnya. Tapi itu tidak terdiri dari subject dan verb. Contohnya ya in bahasa ya, celana panjang bahan apa ya, jeans segala itu kan panjang ya, right? The word so long, it's not sentence, it's just phrases. Right? Karena itu hanya sebuah subjek saja. Long pants red, let's say jeans, contohnya seperti long pants blue jeans, right? It's a group of words but it's not consist of subject and verb. Nah, ada lagi phrases itu contohnya gimana ya? Go out with. Nah, itu kan memang itu namanya verb phrase. Nah, kata frase kata kerja. Nah, enggak ada subjeknya. Subjek hanya yang ada hanya verb, which is go aja seperti itu, right? Nah, so this is also quite confusing, I'm sure yeah for ya, which is maybe that makes you confused. Gimana Miss nanti kita membedakan bahwa itu adalah clause atau phrases ya? Kita lihat nanti itu ada subjeknya apa enggak gitu. Ada verb-nya apa enggak, right? Kalau itu ada subject and verb, so it means it is clause. Nah, tapi kalau kumpulan banyak kata, tapi dia hanya terdiri dari salah satu saja, subject saja atau verb saja, it called phrases. Oke, okay? Nah, so first now, as I mentioned, sentence must have one subject. One subject and one verb, yeah, right. Nah, as I mentioned before, subject is a noun, right, kata benda. Nah, sekarang kita menuju ke verbnya. Verbnya itu apa aja, Miss? Yeah. Nah, ini cakupannya. Banyak ya kata kerja itu. As I wrote here, verb itu ada to be. Ini pelajaran dari SD ya. I'm sure you still remember, right? Ada to be. Is, am, are, was, were. And then modal. Nah, modal ada can, will, could, may, must, would, should. Nah, ini adalah modal. Then auxiliary. Auxiliary ini apa, Miss? Ini what we call in bahasa Indonesia is kata kerja bantu. Kata kerja bantu ya, right. Terus ada lagi verb phrases. Nah, ini tadi yang misalnya bilang verb phrases atau frase kata kerja. Ada go out with, hang out to, across from. So this is the verb phrases. Kenapa kok disebut frase, Miss? Ya, subjeknya nggak ada, right? Itu kecuali kalau nanti I go out with my boyfriend, nah itu baru nanti itu adalah sebuah kalimat, right? Kemudian verb itself, kata kerja itu sendiri, like makan, minum, tidur, belajar, memasak, belanja, berlari, nah that's the verb itself. So if I have a word like this, I will, I'm gonna ask you, is it a sentence or not? Nah, misalnya tulis banyak nih, ada I will, you do, I am. Nah, let me ask you. Are they sentence or not? Ada yang bisa bantu jawab?
Nek,
Any other idea, guys? Yes, ya. Yeah. Semua yang all the words I wrote here are sentence. Miss, kok taunya kenapa lah? Ini sudah ada masing-masing. Subject plus verb. Begitu, right? Kan itu sudah ada subjeknya. Subjeknya apa? I. Verbnya apa? Will. Gitu ya. You do. Nah, it's also sentence. Cuma dia akhirnya nggak lengkap. Karena tidak ada objek. Tidak memenuhi kaidah sebuah kalimat ya. Seperti itu kan sebuah kalimat harus lengkap kan ya. Katanya ada subject, SPOK, right? Tapi kata ini adalah sebuah sudah menjadi sebuah kalimat. Begitu. Cuma tinggal nanti ditambahin objek and adverb of time maybe or adverb of place dan lain sebagainya. So all of them here are sentence, right? Ini semuanya sudah kalimat. Gitu. So any questions before we really go into the exercises?
Not yet, Mom.
Not yet. Okay. All right then. So okay, great. Now let's go then here. Skill one, be sure the sentence has a subject and a verb, right? Kalimat harus terdiri dari satu subjek dan satu kata kerja. Nah, di situ ada pertanyaan tuh guys. There is a number. Can somebody of you read? Rizal ini Mas Rizal ya. Sampai ya. Somebody can try to read example one. Hello.
Example one. Was backed up for miles on the freeway. A, yesterday, B, in the morning, C, traffic, D, cars. Maybe A.
Sorry?
Aku perjalanan
yesterday. I'm sorry?
Yesterday.
Yesterday. Oke. Okay. So, tadi my suggestion is kita pretelin satu-satu ya. Nah, kita lihat dulu yang depan kan. Katanya harus terdiri dari subjek. Wajib itu. Nah, tapi dari kata sorry. Verb-nya yang mana?
Was.
Was. Oke. Okay. So, the verb here is actually verb phrase ya yang dipakai itu adalah oke. Okay. So, yang dipakai di sini itu sebenarnya verb phrase and the verb is was backed up malahan ya. Nah, ini adalah verb-nya. Nah, berarti kita wajib mencari apanya? Jadi yang hilang
subjek,
betul, cari aja jadi. Nah, subjeknya kan kata benda, right? Nah, yang memenuhi standar kan kalau enggak ini kan traffic or cars, right? Karena yesterday and morning is kata keterangan betul, kata keterangan waktu. Memang that's true, which is adverb of time, we can put it in the beginning of sentences or in the at the end of the sentence. Begitu. Nah, tapi even though you put Even though you choose yesterday or in the morning, tetap salah karena subjeknya belum ada, right? Nggak bisa karena harus ada subjeknya. So, which one, C or D?
C, Miss Traffic.
Why? Kenapa kok yang C? Kenapa kok nggak yang cars?
Lebih dari satu.
Right. Yes, it's because the to be yang dipakai di sini adalah singular ya. Jadi so the best answer is traffic. gitu ya, right? Jadi kita harus pretelin dulu. We need to identify which is this sentence already consists of subject atau sudah ada verb-nya belum, seperti itu ya. Oke, okay, that's great. So the best answer is traffic, ya. Yeah. Traffic was backed up for miles on the freeway. Oke, okay, good job everyone. So let's go ahead then. Okay, wait up. Nah, number two. Example two. Somebody wanna read? Somebody wanna try? Hello? Ada yang mau coba?
I'll try, Miss.
Yeah, sure.
Engineers, blah, 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 for work on the new space program. B?
B? Okay, let's take a look on the sentence. Is there any subject? Subjeknya udah ada belum?
Sudah, Miss.
Nah,
sudah.
Which one is the subject?
Engineers.
Good. So, plural ya. Karena ada S-nya. Right. Dan terus di belakangnya ini apa aja, Miss? Kayaknya di belakang ini nggak ada verb-nya, Miss. So, we need to find verb. Nah, the only one, this is, you are lucky ya. Karena satu-satunya di sini yang ada verb-nya itu hanya yang B, yo way. So the best answer is B. Begitu ya. Okay, that's good, everyone. Great. Okay. So, okay then, let's go into the real exercises. Oh, ada tiga nih. Example three, yes please. Somebody wanna try? Boys, nggak ada ya. Laki, ini mana nih? Laki, ini mana lakinya nih? Halo? Nggak ada, ya udah the girl aja. Girls, come on girls. Somebody wanna try?
Oh, let's...
Yuk, boleh. Yes.
Can I try, Miss?
Sure, terserah deh yang siapa yang mau. Apa, ayo. Halo? Kok pada menghilang?
I wanna try.
Yes.
The boy titik-titik going to the movie with a friend. The best answer I think is D.
Will be going. Gitu ya. Oke, kita pretelin dulu ya as usual. Is there any subject?
Ada.
Yes.
Yang mana tuh?
The boy.
The boy.
Oke, okay, great. And then di belakang ini ada verb-nya, Miss, yaitu going ya. Tapi dia butuh pelengkap, right? Sebelum atau di depannya dia butuh verb. Jadi kita butuh verb phrase, right? Jadi mana? Jadi yang dicari adalah kata kerja ya. Nah, Miss, yang A dan B ini memenuhi standar nggak? No, because there is already he. Nggak boleh double subject ya. Jadi A sama B kemungkinan bukanlah jawabannya. Yang kemungkinan jawabannya itu adalah C or D. Nah, kenapa kok nggak yang C?
Double.
Yes, that's true. Or beside that, it's not the best answer ya. Karena bukan apa ya phrase sambungannya seperti itu. It's relaxing. Jadi no, this is not. So the best answer is yes. D will be going. begitu ya. Okay, that's good. So I hope everyone clear. So let's go into it's because of durasi. Jadi, okay, so exercise one here. Nah, you need to find, you need to classify which is this sentence is correct or incorrect. Nah, like example number one ya. Nah, I itu adalah incorrect ya. Kalimat ini salah, Miss, number one. Nah, salahnya di mana? So, last week went fishing for trout at the nearby mountain lake. Kenapa sih? Let me ask you guys. Why this is incorrect? Kenapa kok nomor satu ini incorrect? Kalimatnya salah. Kenapa?
Karena nggak ada subjeknya.
Can you repeat?
Karena nggak ada subjeknya.
That's true. Great. There is no subject. So, kita pretelin lagi ya. Last week is adverb of time. Adverb of time bisa di depan, bisa di belakang. Jadi boleh. Nah, terus went is the verb. Right. Nah, terus fishing is the object. Right. Terus ini wes nggak penting ya. Nah, subjeknya nggak ada, Miss. So where is the position of the subject? Jadi lokasi posisinya subjeknya harusnya di mana? Di sini ya. That's true. So harusnya last week Eva went fishing gitu or whatever ya. Nama orang pokoknya ya. Last week I went fishing. So that's why this sentence is incorrect because missing. Biasanya Miss Eva kasih suruh murid Miss Eva gitu ya. Jadi enggak cuma ngomong ini correct or incorrect gitu enggak, tapi kenapa kok dia incorrect? Nah, karena missing alasannya jadi harus ada biar benar-benar paham. Missing subject. Right. Nah, subjeknya harusnya di sini. Oke. Okay? Okay, good job. Number two, why this is correct? Number two. You, anyone wanna share idea? Karena udah lengkap ya, right? So subjeknya yang mana, guys?
Schedule of the days.
Yes, a schedule. This is the subject. And then verb-nya?
Can be.
Yes, can be obtained. So let me tell you. Anything yang diawalin dengan an sama the itu dia pasti noun. Contohnya di United States, an apple, a book, itu pasti dia noun, right? Jadi ini sudah aman, sudah ada subjeknya. Nah, begitu. The shopping downtown. Nah, itu juga pasti dia juga kata benda ya. The bank, the school. Nah, itu pasti dia kata benda. Okay, everyone. So, I give you a chance to do number. Let's discuss now ya, number three. Number three, yuk. Anyone wanna try to answer? Oke. Okay.
Salah, ma'am.
Number three, incorrect. That's good. How do you know that?
Karena tidak ada verb.
Verbnya nggak ada. Jadi semua kata yang di sini itu apa, Mas?
Bacaan, ma'am.
It's a noun phrase, ya. Jadi frase kata benda. Jadi That's true, yeah. So let me tell you, yeah. A job on the day shift or the night shift at the plant, this is a subject, right? And then available here is adverb. Nah, jadi dia missing verb. Nah, harusnya di sini tuh ada verb-nya di tengah-tengah sini itu. Jadi dia itu singular, jawabannya kalau enggak is atau was. A job on the day shift or the night shift at the plant is atau was available. Begitu. So it is incorrect number three because of apa tadi? Missing.
Missing verb.
Oke, thank you. Lanjut yuk, number four. Number four, somebody wanna try? Yuk, siapa lagi yang mau coba yuk?
Correct, Mom.
Number four correct. How do you know that?
Ada.
Sudah lengkap, Miss.
Yeah.
Sudah lengkap, Miss. Subjeknya yang mana, guys? Which one is the subject?
The new computer program.
Perfect. Yes, this is the subject. Nah, verb-nya.
Yes.
Yes.
This is the subject. And then?
Incorrect, Miss.
Incorrect, Miss.
Incorrect because of?
Seharusnya provided, bukan provides.
That's great. Yes. That's true. Betul banget ya. Betul bingit, guys. So, bener. Guys, this is true. Sudah terdiri dari subject sama verb. Tapi ada tapinya. Has, kata yang diikutin oleh has, have, had. Okay, let me write ya. So, kalau ada kata yang diikutin oleh has or have atau had, itu ditambahinnya. Sorry. Had, ini wajib menggunakan verb 3. Gitu. Nah, sedangkan ini dia pakai S. Jadi salah, right. Gitu. Jadi harusnya has provided. Ini benar, ini memang sudah verb-nya ya, tapi verb-nya itu enggak pas, bukan gantungannya gitu loh. Jadi harusnya has provided. So, the sentence is incorrect. Alasannya because of wrong verb.
Yeah.
Itu. Okay. Great. And then number five.
Correct, Miss.
Correct. So which one is the subject?
The box.
Verb-nya?
Can be opened.
That's great. Sudah pas ya. Ada subject, and then can be opened-nya adalah the verb. Alhamdulillah, benar. Okay, number six. Somebody wanna try?
Baru mau sholat deh. Oh ya, mau kenapa pergi nak? Mau pergi.
Number six, wanna try?
Incorrect.
Incorrect. Great. Kenapa, Mas?
Gak ada verb-nya.
Gak ada verb-nya. Oke, kita lihat subjeknya yang mana nih?
Asik text for history.
Yep. Class. The assigned text for history class. Perfect. This is the subject. Terus ini ada ini kata contains. Contains itu terdiri dari ya atau berisi. So this is the verb. Nah, jadi gimana? Correct apa incorrect?
Correct.
Sorry?
Double subject.
Double subject. Mana lagi ada subjeknya? Yes, that's true. Ini haram ya hukumnya. Gak boleh. Right? So that's why hilangin salah satu. It atau the assigned for the history class itu ya. So this is incorrect. Because kenapa? Kenapa incorrectnya? Because of global. Number seven. Okay, number seven. Somebody wanna try? Halo, ada lagi mungkin yang mau coba number seven? Sorry, correct. Ada yang jawab correct bukan?
Iya.
Oke. Okay. Okay. Subjeknya yang mana guys?
Papers in the was best.
Yes, this is the papers in the was best basket. Ya, subject. Topiknya mana? Yes, should be emptied. Harus dikosongkan. Seharusnya dikosongkan. So this is the verb. Because of already consists of subject and verb, jadi benar. Okay, good. Number eight. Ada lagi yang mau coba?
Incorrect.
Number eight, incorrect. Because of what? Because of you. Nah, jadi number 8 itu incorrect kenapa?
Enggak ada verb-nya.
Enggak ada verb-nya. Subjeknya ada enggak?
Enggak ada.
Gimana subjeknya ada enggak?
Mungkin yang departure itu, Miss.
Departure before dawn on a boat in the middle of harbor. It's the iya, jadi semuanya di sini ini tuh it's a noun phrase, guys. Jadi yes, ini semuanya adalah subject. So missing apa yang hilang?
Missing
verb. The butcher before down on a boat in the middle of the harbor is late. Contohnya seperti itu ya, boleh ditambah apapun ya, yang penting harus diikuti dengan verb. So, okay, this is incorrect because of missing verb. Okay, then okay, incorrect. Then number nine, yep.
Incorrect means incorrect.
Incorrect because
nggak ada subjeknya.
That's good. Seharusnya gimana kalimatnya?
Yesterday I found.
That's true. So it's missing subject. Verb-nya udah ada belum?
Belum.
Verb kata kerjanya ada nggak?
Ada.
found, ya. So this is the verb. Jadi yesterday I found, begitu subjeknya. Yesterday Eva found an interesting article on pollution. So it is incorrect. Okay, great. And then number 10.
Incorrect.
Number 10 incorrect karena
double verb, miss.
Double verb, double verb. Yang mana yang double verb?
Is and process.
Oh. Sorry, verbnya itu is processes ini. Oke.
Okay.
Gimana? Subjeknya yang mana? Is there any subject here?
The new machine.
The new machine is the subject. Terus verbnya udah ada belum?
Sudah.
Sudah. Nah, jadi terus kalimatnya ini correct apa incorrect?
Correct, miss.
Correct.
Incorrect.
Nah, incorrectnya kenapa?
Processes.
Double verb.
Ini gimana?
Harusnya proses.
Harusnya proses aja. Gitu.
Processing.
The new machine is processing, gitu ya. 50% more than the previous machine. Right. So, the problem is on here, guys. That's true, ya. Is processes. As we know, okay, where should I write here? So here. Jadi kalau dikasih to be itu harus diikutin dengan verb in atau to be diikutin dengan verb tiga. Dengan verb tiga. Eh, sorry. Huh? Can I write here? Verb tiga, begitu. Ini sudah ketentuan ya, right? Jadi pilihannya kalau mau tetap pakai is harusnya processing. Okay? Atau dengan is processed bukan processes. Or pilihannya lagi nggak perlu pakai is, hanya pakai processes saja. Right. The point is on the grammar, okay. Jadi kalian, jadi kita kan tadi udah meretelin satu-satu, which is, oh ini sudah, we already identify ada subject, ada verb, right? Sudah ada verbnya, but tidak hanya terhenti sampai situ, verbnya itu gatuannya itu udah bener apa belum, right? Sama seperti yang number 4 ini tadi has provides di sini, padahal. Dia di situ harusnya provided, not providers, seperti itu. That's why this sentence is incorrect, right? Terus habis itu, the new machine is processes. Harusnya padahal adalah is
processing.
Atau is processed atau processes saja, nggak pakai is. Gitu, guys, ceritanya. Susah nggak?
Susah.
Susah, miss. Susah enggak? Susah lah. Masa enggak? Yes, so yes, something like that. We just ini kita baru mengidentify ya, which is it is true, this is correct or incorrect, right? This sentence, this type of questions, pola dari kalimat ini tuh hampir sama seperti yang written expression. Written expressions kan kita harus mencari ini ya, apa yang salah ya atau yang kurang tepat, seperti itu. Nah, jadi kalimat kalau Miss Eva ya, I said to my students, which is actually the easier one is written expression. Why? Ya karena akhirnya kamu tahu bahwa kata ini tuh kurang tepat, yang kata ini yang salah, seperti itu. Tapi ada beberapa murid yang bilang, aku nggak paham, mau miss, yowes yang multiple choices aja gitu. Jadi yang ABC, kalau menurut I, for me, my staff ya, personally, multiple choices is difficult for me. I prefer to choose a written expression, karena dibaca lengkap, itu akhirnya tahu ini yang salah, seperti, it's a reflections of our life sebenarnya. Manusia tuh sukanya nyacat, lihat kesalahan orang, wah ini jelek, gendut, kebrot gitu ya. Tapi ketika harus mencari yang benar dari orang itu, pasti lama gitu nemunya. Yeah, so something like that. Okay. So this is what. Any questions, guys? Maybe. Wait. Yeah. Any questions? Any questions, everyone? I make my... Gak ada pertanyaan? Not yet. Jadi kalau gak ada pertanyaan, nanti kita lanjut next meeting ya. To, insya Allah yesterday, tomorrow to discuss other skills, right? So, okay, everyone. I hope you all not getting confused because of me. Semoga nggak menambahin beban hidup kalian ya. Okay, so thank you for having the class with me today, this evening. So I hope you got some of knowledge and some of what is it, comprehensions to support your English, right? So thank you so much for the time, Miss Cita. So I'm gonna see you tomorrow, inshallah.
Thank you, Zeva.
Thank you, bye everyone.
Thank you, you guys. Don't forget your absent. Okay, guys. See you next time. And good evening.
Good evening.